Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to see the remaining parts of CRO and also what happens when all these parts come together and how does a CRO work. In this video, we are going to learn the other parts of CRO. We have in the previous videos, video number 2 and video number 3, we have seen two most important parts of CRO. That is CRT, cathode ray tube, and time-based circuit. We have learned in video number 1, the introduction of CRO, that CRO consists of 7 main parts. Out of these 7 parts, we have already seen the most important part of CRO, that is cathode ray tube, which is also termed as heart of CRO. Cathode ray tube is a vacuum tube which is kept horizontal and it is used to display the image on the screen. So it uses the electron beam, deflects the electron beam by either using electric or magnetic field and generates the signal on the fluorescent screen. Then we saw what is time-based circuit, the second integral part of CRO, which is nothing but a sawtooth wave generator. Time-based circuit is connected to the horizontal deflecting plates and it is providing the sawtooth wave to the horizontal deflecting plates, so that the electron beam gets deflected horizontally on the screen of CRO, which is the screen of CRT, and this helps in creating the true shape of waveform to be analyzed on the screen of CRO. So out of the 7 parts, we have seen already in the previous videos what is cathode ray tube and what is time-based circuit. Let us now concentrate on other parts of CRO. Along with this, we are going to learn what is the meaning of synchronization and blanking. Then we will see again another part of CRO which is in detail, that is trigger circuit, and then how all these parts, 7 parts coming together, get integrated and work and then create the screen on signal on the screen and analyzes it. Hence we will see the working of CRO. So the other parts of CRO include vertical and horizontal circuits. Now these vertical and horizontal circuits are usually amplifiers. Vertical amplifier or vertical circuit is used to amplify the signal which is going to the vertical plates, which are Y plates. Horizontal amplifiers or horizontal circuits are going to the amplify the signal which is going to the horizontal deflecting plates. So vertical circuit helps in amplifying the input signal to the desired level. It also provides the DC voltage to the Y deflecting plates, which enables the proper positioning of the beam in the vertical direction. Horizontal circuits are comprises of sweep generators and trigger circuits. They are also used to provide DC voltage to X plates, which help the positioning of the beam in the horizontal direction. The next two parts are the high voltage and low voltage power supplies. The high voltage power supplies goes to all the parts of CRT, that is cathode ray tube. Low voltage power supplies goes to the other parts of CROs like vertical circuits, horizontal circuits, then trigger circuits, time based circuits. There are two types of power supplies in CRO, as I said, low voltage power supplies and high voltage power supplies. Low voltage supplies go to the electronic circuits of the CRO like amplifiers, sweep circuits, trigger circuits. High voltage power supplies, they all go to the different parts of CRT like electron gun assembly, then the vertical and horizontal deflection systems or deflecting plates. So out of the 7 parts, we've already seen CRT and time-based circuit. Now we've seen what are vertical circuits, horizontal circuits, and high and low voltage power supplies. The only part of CRO that is remaining to be seen is trigger circuit. Now before we see what is trigger circuit, we must see what is synchronization. Now synchronization basically means locking of frequency of the time-based circuit and the input signal, so that when the input signal is given to be displayed on the screen to the Y plates, at the same instant we can apply the sawtooth wave to the X plates through the time-based circuit. So the two signals will be synchronized and a proper signal will be created on the screen of CRO. If the input signal and the sawtooth wave going to the horizontal circuit, horizontal plates, they do not synchronize, then in that place your wave pattern will not be a stationary wave pattern on the screen of CRO. if you want a steady and a stationary wave pattern and a proper wave pattern to be displayed on the screen of CRO, it's very important that all the input signals that are being given to the CRO to different plates or to the different deflection systems should be synchronized with each other. So what do you mean by synchronization? It's method of locking of frequencies of the time-based circuit to the frequency of the input signal so that the stationary display of wave pattern is seen on the CRO screen. To display a stationary wave pattern on the CRO screen, the horizontal deflection should start at the same point as the input signal given to the vertical plates. And in the each cycle, this should match. When this happens, we say that the horizontal sweep voltage is synchronized with the vertical input signal to be displayed on the screen of CRO. It means that the instance your vertical plates start receiving the input signal to be displayed, at the same instant you should provide the sawtooth wave to the horizontal plate so that the input signal to be displayed going to the Y plates and the horizontal sawtooth wave going to the horizontal plates should match with each other at every sweep cycle to create a steady and a stationary wave pattern on the screen of CRO. So synchronization again is a method of locking the frequency of the time-based generator to the frequency of the input signal going to the vertical deflecting plates so that a stationary wave pattern is seen on the CRO screen. Now the synchronization is carried by the last part of CRO that we have to see, which is called as a trigger circuit. So trigger circuit is an electronic circuit which produces a trigger pulse and it is used to switch on the time-based circuit at the same instance as the input signal is being given to the vertical deflecting plates so that the input signal and the horizontal signal which are going from the time-based circuit to the horizontal plates match in each sweep cycle to create a steady wave pattern on the screen of CRO. So the basic function of a trigger circuit is to produce a trigger pulse to achieve synchronization of input and the horizontal sweep signal to get the steady wave pattern on the screen of CRO. So what does a trigger circuit do? It does synchronization of the input signals going to the CRO. The circuit monitors the input signal, detects the point where it reaches a selected level, produces a trigger pulse. Now this trigger pulse is fed to the time-based generator, acts as a command signal to the signal time-based generator and starts sweep cycle of the time-based. Used for synchronization to display a stationary wave pattern on the CRO screen. So now we've seen almost all the parts of CRO. Let's put them together in the block diagram and see how it works. You can see we have all the 7 parts of the CRO on the screen. This is your CRT. Then we are showing the vertical deflecting plates and the horizontal deflecting plates. Vertical deflecting plate is connected to vertical amplifier, which will amplify the signal to be produced and then it gives to the Y plates. Horizontal or X plates are connected to the horizontal amplifier. Whatever signal goes to the X plates goes to the horizontal amplifier, gets amplified and is given to the X plates. Then we have a time-based circuit which is connected to the horizontal amplifier to give the sweep voltage to the horizontal plates or the X plates for horizontal deflection. And obviously the trigger circuit is connected to the time-based circuit and trigger circuit is also connected to vertical amplifier. Then we have high voltage power supplies and low voltage power supplies. So all the 7 parts of CRO you can see over here. To X plates you can give 2 types of signals. Either you can give internal signals by making use of time-based circuit or you can also give any signal of your choice through external circuit also. So at one time only one signal can be given, either the sweep voltage through time-based circuit internally or any signal of your choice externally. In that case time-based circuit will be switched off. So now how a wave is generated on the screen of CRO. Let us say I want to display this sine wave on the screen of CRO. So the sine wave to be analyzed on which the measurements are to be performed of which the parameters are to be measured, the sine wave which is to be displayed on screen of CRO to be analyzed is given to the vertical amplifier. Now as soon as this signal which is to be displayed on the screen of CRO, this sine wave, this Y input is given to the vertical amplifier, a part of it will be fed to the trigger circuit at the same instance. So the trigger circuit will generate a trigger pulse and it will go to the time-based circuit. The time-based circuit will get switched on. It will generate a sawtooth voltage, a ramp voltage, which will be connected to the horizontal amplifier. So the Y input, the sine wave to be displayed on the screen of CRO goes to the vertical amplifier. At the same instance, due to the synchronization carried out by the trigger circuit, a sawtooth wave will be given to the horizontal amplifier by the time-based circuit. So the sine wave through the vertical amplifier will go to the Y plates, and similarly a sawtooth wave, a ramp voltage through the horizontal amplifier will reach the X plate, and they both will start at the same sweep cycle, and the combination of sine wave to the Y plates and the sawtooth wave to the X plates create the sine wave on the screen of CRT. This is on the screen of CRO. This is how, by bringing together all the parts of CRO, we can not only generate the signal on the screen of CRO, but we can also perform measurements on that particular signal. So this is all about the trigger circuit, synchronization and the working of CRO. The last thing that we have to see is what is blanking. Now we have seen that when a sawtooth wave is given to the horizontal amplifier or the horizontal plates, it retraces its path back to the starting point at the end of the horizontal deflection. So that retrace path will be visible and it does not create a good visual display. So a sweep waveform derived from the sawtooth wave generator forms the trace across the CRT screen by dragging the electron beam across the screen face inside the CRT. The retrace is quick but it is visible. The line from the right to left, this line is unnecessary. So we don't want that the retrace path should be visible, it should be invisible. So the retrace path is made invisible by increasing the negative voltage of the grid and therefore thereby decreasing the intensity of the image on the screen during the retrace time. So what is blanking? Blanking is making the retrace path invisible by applying a negative voltage on the grid of the CRT, which effectively cuts off the beam during the short retrace interval. Blanking is making the retrace path invisible so that the retrace path is not visible to us because we are only interested in the sweep. So during the retrace time, the retrace path is made invisible by increasing the negative voltage of the grid and thus cutting off the beam during a short interval of the retrace time. So in this video, we have seen the other parts of CRO, that is the vertical circuits, horizontal circuits, the trigger circuits. We've seen what is synchronization and blanking, and also if all the parts come together, how the CRO works, creates an image on the screen and also performs measurements on it. Thank you.